Finally, we have found the temple of the drowned god. This place was once a place of worship. Now, bones of the fallen litter its hallways.
Sometimes it's for the best that the gods don't answer to prayers.
Hello everyone and welcome back to the Hive and welcome to the final mission, the Drowned God. And welcome to a mostly resource-free environment. No, actually this doesn't look that bad. I've got a couple of pawns here. It's good to me, so let's move over here. I've got the... Ooh, damn, this is one fancy temple. Not gonna lie. So let's align the camera properly. And let's build our hive here. I guess that's as good a spot as any. Here we have... Oh, more Chalatoi. And what else do we have here? Even more Chalatoi. Oh, really fancy ghost Chalatoi. Oh, Chalatoi Wraith. And some... Damn, those are some... really, really big Chalatoi. And there's probably an even bigger dude inside. Okay.
I can feel the orb of life's presence. Its power radiates on these halls. The fallen Chalatoi champions are brought to this temple. If they are worthy, they will be raised to serve in undeath. If not, they will be tossed to the depths below. The orb of life lies in the main chamber. We must find a way to reach it. But first, defeat the temple guardians.
Will do. So, here we go. Let's get you to harvest straight away. Let's get two more workers. I'm going to collect all these resources. So there are six fishing spots here, which is pretty decent. So we also want to claim this area because there's minerals. And do they have a base? It doesn't look like it, so this shouldn't be too difficult. Ooh, that's just a bed. You can harvest here, you can. And those are a little bit beefier. They have 400 hit points. I recall those other ones only having 300, like these ones here. But then again, they also look... Unliving Champion. Undead Revenant. So I probably killed these guys previously. Those guys, they no longer have skin. That's pretty creepy. These guys have 3000 hit points. Not a whole lot. I've beaten guys with 1000 hit points, so that's really not super impressive. Let's call another worker just so I can get all these pawns here to be worked on. Not that I really would need it, because I'm going to exhaust these pawns here sooner or later anyway, and then I can just move on to the next ones here, but I might as well do it. And here we go. Get more of these guys here. May as well equip my guys with stuff. Yeah, I'm still wondering whether I actually get more stuff when I already have all my slots filled. I think so, even though I'm not 100% sure. But anyway, you can get this and that, and maybe... Yeah, I'll save some for later units. Let's get the medic. I may as well build at least one medic in this game while before I finish it. Provide there are no extra levels or expansions or whatever. And once I've got those guys going, I can take out these guys. Then these guys here, obviously. And ooh, look at that. Some fancy mechanisms here. That looks pretty cool. Then we can invade the temple because the doors are now open. Wonder how tough these guys are. I mean, their stats are pretty decent. And I wonder whether they have any extra abilities. So here we have the medic. Yes, he just auto heal. Okay, healing circle. Okay, I hope you can also just heal directly. That would be very convenient. Let's get a couple more of these. Then we can move out. Then again, your defense pretty good. Attack's pretty terrible, but then again, you're a medic, you're not. You look pretty funky and likes to jump around like this. Then again, you're support, you're not an attack unit, so what do I expect? Let's equip you with something fancy. Such as this and that and maybe this one here. Same goes for you guys. Yeah, I may as well give that to you because why not? And this, and let's save the rest for different units. So make you group 2 for now. Let's just move out. I definitely want those ranged units.
Not enough food.
So let's go for these guys here. Let's check that out. Seems to be decent enough. It doesn't really last all that long, so maybe it's more for post-combat healing, not really for in combat. Nope, not going to dissolve that. Some herbs, it's always nice. Dissolve those too. And an amulet. Whoa, I got a lot of items from these guys. Could be intentional though. So let's just see how. Those guys took quite a beating, so let's just see how strong the healing circle is. Oh, so the guy is healing units automatically. That's good. So that's just a bonus thing, pretty much. I like that. So you move over here. And yeah, there are my ranged units. Let's max those out. These works are all still busy. So what I thought you could heal these guys, so I'm pretty sure you did do some healing stuff, so why aren't you doing it now? And you did do that outside the healing whatever. Let's just everybody attack that guy. And a horn. Yeah, I'm pretty sure those guys are designed to all give you bonuses. Or items, rather. So you guys can get some stuff too. You don't really need defense items. I may as well give that to you. You can get, I don't actually have all that many weapons, to be honest. So you can give that to you and the rest. You're going to get stuff later. Let's get the avatar. Retreat to high. Oh, that's just the usual function here. Alright, just one lizard left. Shouldn't be too much of a challenge. I'm going to leave the healer here for now. I'm kind of wondering whether he's going to get experience just for being on the battlefield. Because I think, look at the tabletop mount here. I think experience is a global thing. It almost looks like this has its own tent. It probably doesn't. It probably was the tent of this guy here. But I like to think it's a lizard who does that. So, go, got some nice items here. This bat here scares me all the time, really. And it looks like you don't get experience for just being around. Maybe you just actually have to kill stuff. Then again, that wouldn't explain why this guy already has that much experience. And to be honest, those lizards kind of suck. So they probably don't really give all that much experience in the first place. Okay, so it looks like he does heal, but only when he wants to. I don't get this guy. Yeah, whatever. You can tag along. Maybe I was too low on food. Does this guy use food? Maybe. I didn't actually want to put you in a group with those guys, but never mind. So let's do it like this. And let's move on over to these guys here. In the meantime, we can build some more stuff. Definitely want the wasps. And why haven't I reached my unit? Do these guys here? Oh wait, no, they only cost. Wait, do the workers add to my unit count?
We require more food.
I think they might actually do, and I didn't pay attention to that because in a lot of games they don't. That would be hilarious because then I could actually just max out my army, not really pay attention to whatever else I want to build really. Right, time to kill these guys here. Yeah, those guys, they should be beatable. Even for my comparably weak troops now. Yep, and they all drop items. These guys even seem to be weaker than the other guys, but maybe it's just because my army isn't that much larger, but maybe it does make a difference. Ooh, and here's a box. Sweet. Let's just dissolve all of this. And a pelt. Albino pelt apparently worth a lot in the hive. So you can retreat and you can get this chest for me. Was there a chest over here? Doesn't look like it, there's just a lot of minerals. Here are my wasps. And I want to max you out too. Yeah, I'm pretty sure workers do count against the limit because now I can build those two rhinos and then I can still build a medic and then I have all the units I can build. So this really should be a unit cap the workers count to. Alright, so our army is as ready as it'll ever be. So we can just walk in through the front door. It's not like there's any other door in the first place. So, but there's a lot of bones here. Indeed, all the lizard bones. And oh, I didn't really see you there because the walls went. Oh, hey. Oh, oh. Just see how tough you guys are. Not so tough. Not so tough at all. Maybe you're just there so I can farm all your items. Which strikes me as sensible. So let's get everybody down here. Yeah. These guys, they do heal automatically, and I like it. Ooh, 30 DNA. Not bad. Not bad at all. Maybe I can actually. That weapon is pretty good, so let's see. The medic, you don't really need a weapon, so you can get this one here. That amulet's pretty good as well, I think gives you extra health. Yeah, and also leech life ability. Yeah, I would say we're doing good enough here. So let's just go after these guys here. I could change the camera perspective, but it's just more cinematic this way. Let's just see how much cinematic damage you guys take. These guys aren't so tough. They aren't so tough after all. Nope, not at all. Not much problem. And they stop drop. Oh, now they drop items again. So awesome. You can collect this and then just gang up on these guys one by one. I mean, I pretty much killed all of you once, provided you are the champion that I killed. Which you could be, or maybe not, you never know. That's just healing circle everybody. Ooh, jewels. This looks pretty good. 40 DNA, not bad. Tide Crusher, Carapace. Barnacles on top, that sounds not as fancy as it could, so let's give you that because you don't really have anything else. So, and yeah, plus 5 defense, yeah. With all these bonuses from the queen and whatnot, this is actually, yeah, my units are really considerably beefier than they used to be. So the question is, am I ready for those? Is that the little monkey? Oh no, that's an eyeless frog abomination. So let's try to aggro you. Got one fancy helmet. So you're fast. At least fast compared to my units. Nope. But you're not so tough really. No, this isn't even worth it. So nope. No problem at all, not if you gang up on this guy with everybody. And you are worth a lot of experience. It's good. I appreciate that. So I like that you have a corpse, even though you're at least your equipment seems to be real, but your body seems to be spectral. But I like it. So I'm curious about the final boss. I mean, there has to be a final boss. There's just no way this massive arena-like chamber with this pond here in the middle, the temple of the drowned god, that there's no boss battle. What's up with you? Are you stuck? Don't tell me you're stuck. Why can't I? Did you somehow like phase out? And oh, now you come out, you somehow glitched through this, and now you're on the pond, and not in the level main area. Oh, that's just great. Can I aggro? Nope. I don't think I can attack my own units, or can I? Because if I, you know what? Let's just de-equip you, and then let's kill you. Provide I can actually. I don't think I have a forced attack, or do I? Nope, doesn't look like it. Maybe with an area attack. Let's see whether it works. Oh, it's not just you doing that. Maybe I can get you out of. Oh yeah, that looked really really fancy when doing it in the water. Oh, now he actually freed you. Okay, that's good to know. So you can free your units that way. It's good to know. So let's move on to this guy here. Everybody attack, and you guys can set up a healing circle here just in case. And yeah, your hit points, they are melting, and your defense is actually pretty low. Brother, the ever-living is no longer alive. Yep, that wasn't too bad. Oh, okay.
These walls have the following carvings written on it. The chained children return. Under the seven-pointed star, Eye of Creation shall shine.
These symbols. It's almost as if those were meant for us. We must solve this puzzle to open the chamber doors.
Okay, so another fancy puzzle here. And here we have, oh, just more lizards. Not quite sure, I mean, where, not quite sure where even the mechanic here is. Oh, the weight puzzle. Oh, maybe I need to put different units with a different weight on there. Who knows? In any case, I think I'm going to murder you guys here first, because flash renders, you don't look so tough. I can probably tag you on. So you guys can get going here. You guys can start killing these turtles. Nothing personal. So we keep our food supply steady. And oh wait, is there a door here? It looks like it. The door here as well. So, hey, how do I get in here? Do I have to solve the puzzle before I can get in here? I thought it was a puzzle for the main gate. But maybe it isn't. In any case, let's move on. These guys here, yeah, shouldn't be much of a problem. So let's get going. Everybody seems to have undead elite troops. The lizard men, they had them, and whoop, retreat. Kill this guy here. And then let's kill that guy. Here we go. And where are my medics? Oh, yeah, you participated in combat. Probably not what you should do, but then again, if you're not healing, you may as well do that. And where's my... One of you was really under-equipped, probably the weak one. Nope, apparently not. Let's re-equip you. Oh, that wasn't actually what you were wearing, but never mind. Anybody here who's... Oh, these hunters here. And yeah, I may as well give you this, but I think I want someone else to have the defensive item like this one here. 10 defense. I don't know why these guys are still so weak. They should be stronger at this point. But maybe it's just that the game enemy likes getting up on them and that they're just so fast they're always at the front line. So like right now. Didn't see you there because of the camera angle, but never mind. Oh, there's more of you. That's okay. I can take you guys. How about I kill you next and then you. Oh, you dropped some meat. Yeah, undead meat. That's what you... Yeah, unknown meat. Yeah. Yeah, unable to tell. It's probably for the better, really. And I got quite some upgrades here, but I still don't have enough to get any more upgrades. So, let's get in here. Do you just have to put someone on there? Oh, I can't get in there before. I don't even know where is the puzzle here. Is this a puzzle? Do I have to put guys on here? That's... Oh yeah, well, you're flying. It would be hilarious if you could do the weight puzzle even though you're clearly flying. Okay, so I put someone on there. Let's just see whether it works with wasp. Just out of curiosity. And it doesn't. So let's take the legionnaires. Maybe that works. No, maybe just not heavy enough. Let's put even more guys on there. I think these guys here, yeah, they're finished. So you can harvest this turtle here. You can harvest that one. And you can harvest this one here. Okay, the queen's barely heavy. Oh yeah, so now this actually works. Are there more... Wait, why are you floating so high in the air? Anyway, guess I have to put more guys on there. Let's take the avatar. You should be heavy enough. You look like my heaviest unit. And let's take maybe a rhino. Oh, maybe you aren't heavy enough. Do I have to put a very specific weight on each of these plates here? We'll see. At least there's glow here, so that does indicate that I did something right here. It reminds me of this game. Yeah, where you have a bunch of units. Well, not a bunch of units, a bunch of figures. I think in the version I played was bears, and you had to balance them on the scale. They were heavy ones and basically taught children about different weights and the relation of size and mass and stuff. And this doesn't really seem to work all that well. I've got this one here figured out. Maybe the avatar's too heavy. Maybe I have to put lighter guys on there. We'll see. Let's start with maybe wasp. Again, I'm not really sure whether wasp counts here. I mean, it's not really a flying unit in the sense that there's a real flying mechanic in this game. It seems more like that it does. Does this one here count too? I really don't know. Let's just send you over here. That would be possible, which it apparently isn't. Nope. Well, let's try to get a little bit closer. So it turns out I have to put on a very specific number of guys on here. I'm not really sure whether all these units actually count as having different weight categories, but this one here, stop on there, please. I have to figure out a way to get these guys actually to stop on the platform here. Here we go. You can get over here. So I'm not really sure whether the different units actually have different weight, whether game rules just said, or whether it's just the number of units, but it doesn't really matter. Send everybody on here. No, that doesn't seem to work. So maybe it's just too many guys. That could very well be the case. So let's start with you. Then you. Then you. Well, you're a wasp, so you don't really count. I think you don't count. You may very well count. So send you on there. Now you just shoved away the medic. Nope, that doesn't work. So have the right weight on. I don't really want to mess around with the other switches now because I've got those figured out. So here is. So it's just the queen here. Question is, maybe every single unit can counter that. So let's try to figure that out. Let's get you over here. Yeah, build another hive here because why not? And let's see where that works. The queen, you leave. Wasp, step on. No, so either you don't count or you're not heavy enough. Here I have those two guys. See how this works out. Okay, so it looks like the hunters alone are heavy enough to make this count here. So let's get you over there. Let's see whether you can put enough weight on here. So it doesn't seem to be an upper limit. So if I put more on the switch, it still seems to be okay. Okay. Just put everybody on here. Come on. Maybe I don't think I have too many guys on here. Because it was already fiddly enough. And it would kind of, well, I thought it would maybe be 1, 2, 3, 4 units, but it doesn't really seem to be the case. Any case, I don't think I can remove you here. So maybe these units that consist of multiple units count as different units? I really don't know. Oh, there we go. So apparently you only need to put one very light unit on there. Oh, there we go. Yeah.
The puzzle box of the great old ones. Its power can be used to reach the final chamber. If you are not careful, its lies will fill your mind.
The puzzle box of the great old ones. That is something. That is definitely something, so just wow. But anyway, so Is this how the great old ones spent their leisure time that. Anyway, so you guys should get that. I was just playing around. This is like a Rubik's cube. Oh, probably isn't. Oh, cutscene. Ah, there we go.
This poisoned earth carries the stench of the dead. We must dig our way to the second chamber.
Oh, okay, so we can now have the puzzle box, which is not an item, apparently. So, dig our way. So, where was that? Where was that digging site? Can we get. Oh, I see. Actually, you guys can get over here. You guys can get over here, and you guys, and you guys, and you guys, and you too. This is cute. Look at those cubes. Yeah, God am I this game for some creativity. And how do I get rid of these? Maybe I can attack them? Well, then again, workers can attack, so it shouldn't be That shouldn't be the limitation, really. Yeah, we'll see. Let's just get everybody over here and then maybe we can... No, I can't just click on them, so... Nope. Yeah, let's see. Maybe... Combat units can... Can attack those? No. Okay, if that's not the case, then who can get through there? Don't tell me we have to approach from that side. That would be silly. For some reason I didn't notice this before. I could have sworn that wasn't there. I guess I just overlooked it. Nope, I can't really click on this. Well, I can click on this, but it doesn't really seem to have any effect. Odd. Those medics are slow. Nope, doesn't look like it. I mean, it says use worker to dig tunnel, and it's capitalized oddly. I mean, either tunnel should be capitalized too, or worker and dig shouldn't be capitalized, but whatever. But it doesn't seem to work that way. Do I have to dig through a very specific... Oh yeah, here we go. Do I have to dig through a very specific part of the tunnel here first? Okay, why did it work then? Okay, let's try this one here. Oh, what? You can get all the way up here? What the hell? Oh, so this apparently does count as digging. So they can dig through here, it just takes forever. Yep, maybe should have paid a little more attention to that, but who cares. Oh, this is going to take long, isn't it? Yeah, it is. Okay, so we can apparently speed this up by using multiple workers on one stretch. And it also seems that some of these segments can't be dug away. So, like these ones here, they seem to be undiggable. You can order your workers to work on them, but nothing seems to happen. So it looks like we have to, like, same for this one here. So it looks like there's one specific path we have to get through here. Same for this one here. Come on, give me something here. Yep, there we go. This one here should be the next one, I hope. Or maybe, yep, it is. Let's try this one here. Yep. And yeah, that one worked as well. Slowly digging our way through here. Oh, now it's a cube, a square again. Ah, oh, whatever. Ooh, finally. That took forever. So anyway, let's just get in here. Why did we even do this? I guess we want the toys of these guys here. They better have some toys, but it doesn't really look like they have anything here, but maybe something's going to pop up on that altar. You never know with this game. So, yep, you just come for me, I don't even care. Yeah, and dead. And more undead meat. Ooh, and an amulet. And good thing I brought the workers. Well, I didn't really have a choice because we have to bring them anyway to dig through the tunnel. So I can pick up the treasure chest. Dissolve that. This one here. Yeah, probably have some free workers here right now. Or maybe, yeah, I've got you. So you can build... You can build a worker then, because why not? So, and you guys can get this treasure chest here. You're the chosen one. Open the chest. We're not going to collect those coins. We're going to collect these items here. So what do I have here? Almost the first plague. Ooh, poison. That's pretty good. Health plus... Ooh, attack minus one. Still very good. Permafrost essence. Okay, that's interesting. So... Maybe I can give that to some of you guys. So that did, yeah, that might actually be the better choice here, especially for you because you don't have one of those items in the first place. And let's check. Leave the medics out of here and let's check. So you're a hunter. Yep, you don't really need the defense, but whatever. So you can use this, and I'll just give that to you as well, because why not? I don't really care all that much. So, ooh, I hope those aren't actual. Those could actually be actual traps. So, everybody just wait here. Oh yeah, cutscene.
Watch your steps. These halls are protected by deadly machinations, waiting to rend flesh again.
Oh, I see it. Those lizards try to get in there. So obviously, now we have to maneuver all my units through there. Ah, come on. I like that they actually explain where they get their energy from, because they do have this water wheel here. So let's try these guys here first. Stop. Oh, let's not be too hasty here. Indiana Jones style temple. I'm curious just how deadly they are. So one of you will be the victim here. So maybe I should get the medics through there as well. So here we go. No problem. And now you will get killed. Die for the cause. Take one for the team. Who? Oh. Now that I've gone through here, they apparently get deactivated. Okay. Don't tell me they start again while moving my army through here. Anyway, let's just see how much damage my wasps can do here. Let's get the medics through. So, let's see. Ooh, there's another cube. More undead puzzle boxes. Yep, all those items definitely help. I'm doing a fair amount of damage here. So are they, but that's a, no. You don't do that. So I mean, I kind of like that the trap only. Get down here! I want to see something. Kind of like that the trap is only active before you get your first unit through there. But at the same time, it would be nice if we could actually check out just how deadly it is. But yeah, whatever. You just die now. Come on. There we go. Give me a vial. Still can't afford any upgrades, I'm pretty sure about that. Nope. Regeneration ability, so I could just get that. Yeah, let's just get that to check it out, and I don't think I'm going to get all that DNA anyway. And a plus one bonus to attack or defense is nice, but it's not going to be a game changer, I hope. So
the relic requires a sacrifice to fuel its power.
Blood sacrifice? Oh yeah, just some workers. That's okay.
Unfortunate loss for the greater good.
And the door's open. Alright. Well, those workers didn't count against my pop limit anyway, so never mind. And yeah, looks like this is it. Go to take on. You're still here. Okay. Never mind. So they're going to take on the Drowned God. And let's just see what this regeneration ability actually does. Oh, to their full capacity. Well, that's pretty awesome. 6 minute cooldown is pretty good, but it would have been a lot more useful if I had that a couple of missions ago. But you know what? Who cares now? Then again, those upgrades are kind of expensive, so those might actually be the first ones you want to get, provided if you want to do this in the first place. Okay, looks like this is it. Everybody has been healed. I'm actually going to take these workers along, because now that I have all those upgrades, their attack power and defense isn't actually all that bad. Their hit points are pretty bad, but I might as well use them now. It's not like I'm going to use them at any time later in the game. So here we go. Ooh. Okay, looks like we're facing the Necromancer again. And he's still... He could be even beefier than before, not quite sure. Anyway, let's just create a hive here, because that's how we do things. There we go. Yeah, I'm not going to risk it now. And damn, this looks sweet. So I've got this gigantic plant here, then surrounded by several moons, then moons of moons. And those are, by the way, oh no, those are, it's actually another plant. Those all seem to be way, way too close. But whatever. So just everybody go after this guy. I'm pretty sure he's not a, could you please attack me? Thank you. Could you get over here? I'm pretty sure this is not the these area attacks here. Pretty sure this is not the final boss, because come on, get over here. Oh, this is, oh, you can target properly now. Oh, does this have some like life draining aura? Anyway, everybody just attack. So where are you? You guys can actually create a healing field here. And oh, my units are dying rapidly here. Wow, this guy. Oh, get out of there! What are you doing? Yeah, you definitely need to regenerate. I can't fight this guy. Yeah, really, I have to fight this guy in the healing aura. Otherwise, this is not going to go well. I don't know what kind of attack he did there, but that was strong. And my units are still rapidly declining. But still, this guy here. Let's just do our best. And I'm burning through my food relatively quickly, considering how much I have. And there we go. Maybe that was the final boss. I sure hope so. Come on, die already.
We must burn the corpse. He must not be allowed to return to this world again. Our long journey has led to this moment. The Forerunner relic is ours.
Okay. I still have the feeling this isn't quite over yet. I'm just going to rebuild my army just in case, because you never know. We pretty much lost all of these guys here. That's disappointing. Then again, my wasp survived for some reason. That's unusual, but I'm okay with that. Let's just see what they can. Can replace anybody else? Nope, doesn't look like it. So my workers are all dead. That's not really all that surprising. So yeah, I guess going to do some collecting here. Ooh, this is it. Yep, called it. Massive tentacle monster. Oh, how about we just leave for now? I knew we had to kill this guy. Ooh, 2000 hit point tentacles. So I mean, we're rebuilding our army. We may as well, whoa. Yeah, this, I knew this was going to come. Let's just avoid that for now. But why do we have a laser? What the hell? Should probably kill these tentacles here first. Which are not that tough. Probably still avoid this one here. And these area attacks here. Yeah. Still not sure what the hell is up with those lasers. Oh, so he's, what the hell? Anyway, let's just heal up here. And let's kill this guy here. And wow, those attacks are still, they're still very strong. Actually, I have to watch out here that I don't run out of energy, out of food rather, or out of, because I don't really, I mean, I have a decent amount left, but I already lost 500. Oh yeah, damn it, this is not good. Oh, I can get up here. That's good. So yeah, these attacks, they do a lot of damage. So let's avoid this. Oh, whoa. This does, whoa, holy hell, this does a ridiculous amount of damage. So this is really resource management at its worst. So let's get out of here before that cool. Yeah, those tentacles, you have to avoid those. Those do a lot of damage. It looks like I lost more units because I, well, or maybe I haven't rebuilt those. Oh yeah, I lost all those workers. Yeah, I've almost forgot about that. So the hive's losing a little bit of health, but it doesn't really have all that much health in the first place. It doesn't take all that much damage in the first place. Actually, let's try something here. Let's attack from this direction here. Yeah. Then let's just bail out. Ooh, this is one click fest here. Ooh, yeah, let's get, well, for some reason could interrupt the tentacles attack animation. Yeah, dodged that one. Ooh, yeah, we really need to regenerate here. Yeah, I mean, you could call though using the hive here cheese, but I mean, feel free to give me another strategy to do that. And why am I just losing these guys so quickly? Seems okay. So I guess it does. It's probably because these guys here. These guys are all basically single units. So, actually, how many hit points? You have 5. That's not that much. So, because all these guys here have, basically, they are one unit, and the other ones are multiple units. So it's easier to kill them, to kill a single one of those units. Okay. So can I even attack you? Doesn't look like it. So let's just kill all those tentacles first, if possible. So it looks like it's easier. You attack from this angle here. Yeah. So it seems like it's easier to kill those guys separately. Oh, super attack avoid. Looks like that guy's slowing down at least a little bit, so. Come on. Yeah, that really seems to be their weakness, that they are a group and that. Hey, please die. That defeating an individual, one of those units, is a lot easier than. Oh, necromantic energy, whatever that is. It's a lot easier, so you attack from this angle here. Avoid, avoid. Yeah. Actually, maybe I should kill this guy here first. Those guys are. Oh, this one here again. Yeah, these guys, they die so quickly. That's okay, I can. Maybe I should actually stop. Ooh, get out of here. Maybe I should actually stop trying to rebuild all those guys, because they just die so quickly, it might not be worth the food. Probably give these guys here better equipment too. May as well do that now. So yeah, you guys can still join in. So can you guys. Yeah, don't have time for equipment right now. So did I already? Yeah, I did damage you. So oh, this again. Please dodge that. So. Oh, no, get off there. Thank you. Now, let's end this guy here. It seems like the tentacles, they at least slow, destroying the tentacles slow that guy down. I have a feeling the drone god, he was attacking faster. Oh yeah, mine's 110. Wow, I did a lot of damage here. Maybe they just do some sort of like final attack before they go out. Okay, so. Oh yeah, avoid. Oh, yeah. Nope, all the area attacks at once. It's not what we want, it's not what we want. So. Get over here. Those single attacks, they are not that bad. But those area attacks, they're just scary. Oh, no, no! Ah, you're so dead. Yeah, you're totally dead. So this one here is dead too. Oh, and. Whoa! So. Do those guys do super damage when they die? It almost seems like it. Anyway, I need to heal up. And this guy here, can I even attack you before I kill all the tentacles? Because it doesn't look like it. But there's only two left, so it's really not that bad. Do those actually give me experience? Ah, it doesn't look like it. Hmm. What a shame. Anyway, let's regenerate everybody here. Did I lose any of my core units? No, only lost hunters and legionnaires, so it's not that bad. I really need the wasps, because wasps are strong, they are very mobile, and they kind of have the advantage. Oh, being able to distract the tentacles for a while, or at least make them attack from an angle that I don't want to. That I do want to attack them from. Or maybe they don't even do that all the time. So, oh, come on, get out of there. Thank you. Oh, nope. At least there's an indicator. If there wasn't any indicator for those error effects, that would make this impossible. I can kill you before you do that. Yeah, I can. Gonna move back. I'm not going to risk it. Yeah, this hive here, really, you really need that. Whoops. There should be. Wait. Oh, that's just the other hive. Whatever. This guy here still looks like he's going on a crutch. So, can actually probably give you some more equipment. Still not sure how I can actually attack the drowned god, but yeah, we'll get to that sooner or later. And he sure looks scary. He looks like a mix between Cthulhu and that sandpit monster from Star Wars. Which probably in turn is inspired by 1950s science fiction monsters or so. So, avoid. Yeah. Avoid that too. Avoid everything, so. And also avoid that guy, because that death buff is. So, there we go. You're dead. I'll fight you at home. And for some reason he's laser targeting my guys. I don't like that. Okay, so I have to defeat all
the time. Dark God is summoning the void through this world.
Okay, that doesn't sound good.
The orb of wisdom to shield our troops.
Okay, so let's do that. Oh, I see. So this basically like a super shield that can counter his super weapon attack.
Hurry, strike the abomination down before the ritual is complete.
Will do. Yeah, he's not that tough now. I mean, 5,000 hit points. Those guardians had 10,000 hit points, and his defense is no defense, so he's just a sitting duck now. A really, really ugly sitting duck. Oh, and all the tentacles are back. Well, that's cool. What the hell? Why did you even stop attacking that guy in the first place? Wait, really? I can't attack him now? Oh, come on. Do I have to kill all the tentacles first again? Oh, come on. Don't tell me that's true. I mean, I don't even get experience for them, so... And, I mean, I clearly didn't have the firepower to... Yeah, this is still doing fine. I clearly didn't have the firepower to... To just kill him in one... In fact, I'm going to need at least two more goes to do that, so... Not looking forward to that. Oh, whoa. Let's just get out of there. Quickly kill the tentacle here. Yeah, there we go. Let's avoid this area attack here. Wow, this is taking forever. Those guys are still alive. Kind of surprised by that. So let's get into Hive range here and then kill this guy here. Yeah, then I can actually survive that. So, going to save my food now. You know what? I'm actually going to get out of here and equip those items. Let's see whether they can attack me outside of this chamber. I hope not, but we'll see. Okay, I'm getting better at this. You can generally... Thought you guys could attack. You can generally kill the tentacles after it did one attack. It will start to do a second attack, but it's not going to go through with it. And if you avoid the area attack in the meantime, then you're generally good. These guys here are annoying, not because they're all that strong, but because once you've faced them, you pretty much have to go back to base. You can try to kill them before they do their death burst attack, which can work. But downside is that they always target one specific unit of yours. And since all my units are now in a cluster and I don't really want to decluster them. Yeah, so here. Yeah, I did one attack now and now I'm going to be able to take it down before it does second attack. And yeah, I don't really want to decluster. I mean, it still does this piercing attack here, but it's not very strong. So yeah, here we go. And whoa, or maybe I was wrong here. So I almost did it before. Did that attack, so those wasps are really worth their money or worth their food here, because they're excellent for attacking a tentacle, then retreating. Well, not retreating, but changing position, then tentacle strikes the wrong spot, so to speak, on the ground, and then you can strike the tentacle where you actually want to attack it. I'm going to come for you. Just have to defeat all of these tentacles. These two more times, but whatever. Okay, just one more tentacle for now. Oh, that's actually not the position I want you to be in, but who cares? So let's quickly take this out, if that will be possible. Let's avoid that by not stepping into another area that's also going to get hit by Death Burst. Step out of here. For another good way to deal with those exploding suicide chalotoy. Send the wasp out of them. If they are not after a wasp and they don't seem to like to target wasps, then you can... Nope! Ooh, that was close. So yeah, let's go for this guy. Wait, really? Oh, come on, guys. Here we go. That's better. That's a lot better. Oh yeah, so now the tentacles are back, but next time I should be able to take out this guy. Man, this is taking forever. I've been on this for, what, 20 minutes? This is like a Persona length boss fight. Hey, look here. So this guy's after one of my rhinos. So let's just have the boss take care of him and walk away. So yeah, he's not going to get me. I like that he still makes the same noises that... Ooh, that's not actually what I intended. But I'll take it. So this one's probably not the one you should attack first, because you probably want to avoid getting hit by more than one tentacle at once. And now this guy here actually targets one of my wasps slower. That's just great. Oh, probably avoid that. Yeah, you're dead. So I'm not going to move away now. There we go. Let's wait for these attacks to phase out. And then let's have you guys gang up on that guy. And dead. Or maybe not. Whoop, that actually hit the wrong guy, but never mind. Let's heal up and then take on the last tentacle. So here we go. Healing seems to be surprisingly cheap. I remember that to be more expensive, but then again, it's possibly because now that I don't have all these single units anymore, because most of them are dead, maybe it's just cheaper for single units, even if those units are stronger. Anyway, here we go. This one here should go down quickly enough. Oh, provided there's no burst attack. It's going to interrupt my attack routine here. Nope, and now there's another tentacle attack, but it's not a problem. So now that this one is just the last one, I've got all the maneuverability I need. So, here we go. Let's attack this guy. Ooh, the stars are right indeed. Can you please attack this guy? Come on. This shouldn't be so difficult. Anyway, here we go. So, attack this guy. There we go. Bring him down, bring him down, bring him down. Bam! There you go, Salak Cthulhu.
The Drowned God lies defeated.
I've got two queens now. Alright, so that was the final mission. At least I think it was the final mission, we'll see. In any case, yeah, I wonder what's going to happen when I click on continue. Okay, thank you for playing the Hive. Oh, come on, no final cutscene. This concludes our beta 0.14 version of the Hive. Check back soon as we update the game and add more content for community. If you enjoy playing Hive, please leave a review on our... You should really include some more articles here. Steam store page. It's very important for us developers to hear if we are doing the right thing. That is actually true. Do you have any ideas, suggestions for the game? Take part in the development and let us know. Yeah, I want this game to support 1440p properly. It does do so, but all the menus get super, super small and they don't stretch across the entire screen, so it looks kind of ugly. Yeah, so that was a Hive for now. Still not 100% sure about the plot, because, I mean, the plot did tie up. The spaceship did come back, But did they really have to make that introductory cutscene? And then, so here's my theory. The humans left Earth millions of years ago. They came to this planet, then basically devolved into insects. And the reason why the spaceship corrupted them is because spaceship essentially represents the corruptest Earth they fled from. But that's just my fan theory. Anyway, so I did enjoy this game, but the gameplay has to be improved because the AI is not very good. The AI just spams units and sends them to your base. And the only valid strategy is essentially make a huge stack of all of your units and then just go for the enemy and clear out the map. And building hives everywhere on the map is clearly the best strategy in my opinion, because I mean, can you imagine doing the final boss fight without the hive right there to regenerate a unit? Because I can't. If those tentacles gave you experience, that would make things different, because then I probably would have been, I don't know, level 20 when I ended that. And also that last boss fight was really long. That was, all in all, that was almost half an hour long. That was a lot of clicking, and you can't save during the mission. That's another thing. I kind of like that you can't just cheese it by reloading, but then again, that's something that should be left up to the player, because if he basically wants to cheese the game, your choice. And some of these missions are more than an hour long, and you can just pause the game, obviously, but you shouldn't be forced to play it all in one sitting. But anyway, thanks for watching. I think I'm going to end this for now, because there's no new content, but in 2 weeks there's another update. Whether it's going to be a significant update, we will see. But yeah, we'll see. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I shall see you then. Take care, and goodbye. Oh yeah, and if this game gets new contents, new missions, cutscenes, whatever, I'm going to check them out as well. See you then.